Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at the new features in Reminders in macOS Catalina. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So the Reminders app in Catalina has a lot of new features to match the Reminders app in iOS 13. And they work together, of course, through iCloud. So you can update one and see the updates on the other. Now the first thing you'll notice in the Reminders app are these four things right here. They are different ways of viewing your lists. So you can have multiple lists just like before. And a normal way to view them would be to simply view them by list by clicking on each individual list. But you also have these alternative ways of viewing things. For instance, today will show you any reminders from any of these lists that have a due date of today. So you can see them all grouped together even if they're from different lists. If you look at scheduled, you'll see today as well, but also any other reminders in any lists that have a due date or time at all. And notice that you have a plus button under each. You could add a new item directly here. This will go into your default list. Your default list is what you have set under Reminders, Preferences. You can also add new items to Today as well. You just click there at the bottom or use the plus button and you can add one to your default list that will automatically be set to Do Today. Now the All list will show you everything from all of your lists in one long view. So you see each list in the order they are here and you can see every item in it. It's an alternative to just viewing it list by list like that. You can just do all and see everything. You can also add to any list here in this view. And also if you've got completed items here, you can choose whether or not they are shown or hidden. The flagged list allows you to see just the items from all of your different lists that have been flagged. I'll show you how to flag items in a minute. Now a big new feature of the list is the ability to change the icon type and color. So it's pretty easy to do this in iOS 13, but here if you create a new list it doesn't ask you. So you need to go in and do it afterwards. If you click on the name and you're editing the name of the list, but if you double click on the icon then you go into a special mode here where you can edit the name and also change the icon and color. So for instance for groceries let's change to a shopping cart icon and make it a green color. And then for pharmacy I can double click on that and we'll stick with the blue color but change to a shopping cart there as well. So this might make it easier for you to find your list since they would have a different color and also an icon. Notice if I go to the list of all now you can see it uses the color there in the name of the list. Now you have the ability to further organize your lists by creating groups or folders. So let's click on a list to select it and I'm going to create a new group. It's going to create a new group or folder with that list in it. We'll call it shopping and you can drag and drop another list into it as well. I'll put the pharmacy shopping list in there also. And now you can open and close that list. So it gives you the ability to kind of tame your list of lists here if you've got a lot of them. Now when you go to add a new item you get some additional features here. You can enter the name of the item of course. You can also do notes right below it in the next line. But you also have add date, add location and there's the flag there. So now if I flag this particular reminder, hit return to add that item, you could see it's flagged here on the right. And it is now listed under flagged. You also have these other things here. You could add date and it gives you suggestions like today, tomorrow, this weekend, or you can use a custom date for any date there. If you want to get more detailed, just click the I button here and you can do on day, but you can also do on time and add a location. Add location is also over here. So you could click that and select your current location. You can also select when you get into your car or when you get out of your car. And you can add any address or name of a business or something and it will look it up using the Maps app data and you can add that as a location as well. This of course is a lot more useful on the iPhone so you can enter this in on your Mac but then your iPhone is probably the device that's going to remind you when you arrive somewhere. You also get the ability to add a person. And when you add that person, if you're messaging with them, you'll get a notification that you have a reminder pertaining to that person. And that will help you remember to mention something to that person during that conversation. Just as before, you could set priority for things. You can also set reminders to repeat. So it could be a repeating reminder, like something that will remind you every day. and you can add a URL here. You can also add an image. You can do that here with this button, but dragging and dropping is probably the better way to do it. So you can do it from the Finder, from a file, but you can also do it from the Photos app. So in the Photos app here, I could drag a photo and create a new reminder with it or add it to an existing reminder, and you see it's added a photo there. So that's just another element that you can add here to an individual reminder. Likewise, you can add a URL that way. So you can be in Safari here and you could drag a URL into a reminder and you can see it adds it there. These will also appear if you go to share something, like share a URL and say I want to share it in reminders. It'll automatically put that URL as part of the reminder. The Reminders app is really maturing at this point. I use it to keep track of ideas for episodes, ideas for blog posts, ideas for my business. And I also, of course, use it to quickly add reminders to get an alert at a certain time. Usually when I do that, I'm using Siri to add to it. And you can still do that as well, but then it's useful to be able to go in and edit and flag and do all of that. And the new Reminders app gives you even more options to keep things organized. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.